Hi, after watching the video, click the link in the description to download the program.
Hi, my name is Steven Anderson, and today you're going to learn about a brilliant device born from a tragic milestone I personally experienced with my 10-year-old son not so long ago. This life-changing story opened my eyes in more than one way. Not only did I realize how dependent I was on the electricity moguls, but I discovered the path to create a simple system that helped me ever since to generate my own energy daily, which eventually led to the peace of mind I craved for so long. I'm talking about a simple device that can be used by any family around the world and can even change the course of the entire energy industry. The circumstances that led to this unique discovery are so horrifying and deeply disturbing, they'll send shivers down your spine. I'm sure you're already intrigued and you want to know all about how everything happened. Honestly, seeing your own child shivering in darkness and starving for 2 days will certainly take a heavy toll on every parent and can make them look for the wildest solutions not to experience similar situations again. And all that because of a nasty blackout. For this reason, nobody, parent or not, should be dependent on electric companies who suck us dry with monthly electric bills and couldn't care less about our safety. That's why I made it my sole purpose so that everybody would get the chance to live a better life, free from power company monopolies which are suppressing our independence and freedom day after day. But how did I get my son in this situation, you may ask? And why is this event so important to the outside world? Stick till the end of this short and shocking presentation and you'll find out how to create your own energy system that reduces your power bill all year long. I don't know how much longer I'll have this free presentation online, so watch this right now while you still can. Some hope this type of information never reaches the surface and do their best to keep it under the hat. Before we continue, let me tell you who I am and how it all started. My name is Steven Anderson. I'm a 47-year-old scientist from Ellijay, Georgia. Ever since I was a child, I was fascinated by nature. That's how I became a botanist. The main thing that pushed me in this direction is my grandfather's little cottage he built with his bare hands in the middle of rich mountain woods. My father inherited it from him, and I got it when he passed away. It was all I needed for my research, but the worst part about it were the electricity costs. Folks who own such cottages know that high energy bills are somewhat of an issue, and I'm sure they've also been fighting them for years, and nobody ever liked paying through their noses for simple things that everybody should afford, like using the electric appliances without restriction. However, I simply settled, thinking that's the economy, or maybe it'll be better next year, month after month, struggling not to fall behind on bills. All that until the fall of 2017, November 8th, Thursday. The most terrifying experience of my life. The worst storm caught me in the middle of the woods, in the same cottage my father and I used to go every fall to spend a week in the wild. To make things worse, my son was with me. Around 7 p.m., clouds started gathering, but I wasn't worried. I had gone through storms over the years and never had problems, but this time, it was different. The wind was blowing like never before, and trees bent down like willows. After a few minutes, all lights went off. I immediately thought it was a simple blackout. I went to check on my son. He was fine, for the moment. The storm somehow broke a tree right over the only road that led to the closest town, 20 miles away. It also ripped down the power lines, and we suddenly found ourselves without power. Having no other solution, we decided to wait for the power to come back. The cottage was getting cold, and it was getting cold fast. Night came, and still no power. I tried calling the electric company on my cell phone to find out when, or if, power would be restored. But all I got was a pre-recorded message saying that they were aware of the problem, and that it would be between 48 and 72 hours before the power would be back online. Moreover, this cost me my phone battery that was now dead. It got colder and colder. Quickly, the temperature inside reached around 40 degrees. We tried going to sleep, but it wasn't easy. The noise the storm made was like I had never heard before. I didn't have a single watt to charge my phone to call for help to save my son who was shivering and crying. I wrapped my arms around him as I could in a futile attempt to give him what little body heat I had. And then he told me with shivering words what would scar me for the rest of my life. "Daddy, I can't take it anymore. I want this to be over." It was the most devastating moment of my life. I felt like my world collapsed. I felt powerless because there was nothing I could do to protect the one I cared for most. And I simply felt furious. Outraged about the fact that I knew I was the only one to blame for getting in this situation. And worse, for getting my only son in this dangerous situation. I was furious that I was completely dependent on the electric company to have power. And furious about the fact that for so many years, I'd let it slide and thought maybe it'll be better next year, while those money-sucking electricity mobsters bled me and my family dry. Imagine sitting next to your shivering child, living for who knows how many days without electricity, eating only canned food, and that's if you have it in remote areas, not being able to heat your home during cold nights. It was the moment I realized I was at the end of my rope. I swore to myself I'd never put my child in a similar situation again. After 2 days in hell, we managed to go home. I immediately began researching every single energy alternative I could find, hoping to prevent the kind of situation we went through. I made it my sole purpose because leaving my family's well-being in the hands of electric companies clearly wasn't an option anymore. Not only did their power lines always seem to go down in unexpected moments, but their prices had been smothering me for more than a decade. I struggled for months to find a viable solution, but failed time after time. Every prototype needed some kind of fuel, which was very hard to be found in nature, and not only. Moreover, carrying such fuel may be dangerous, so I needed to find a device with clear and simple instructions so that my son could build it if he found himself in a similar situation. It had to be something cheap and fast and easy to assemble, because I definitely didn't have any technical skills to build complicated devices. Being a botanist doesn't really offer those kinds of skills. Many sleepless nights passed, and I was getting tired of surfing the internet for a simple solution. Yet one day, I stumbled upon an article about the Cold War. It immediately reminded me of my grandfather's countless boot camp stories and how the Army kept developing new technology for all kinds of purposes during those times. I remember him telling me he was impressed with a system he had never seen before that looked so ahead of its time. He explained to me in detail how the system was able to grow the waves input by converging them, so that the system focused the sun waves in one spot to increase the overall power output. He then said it was so effective because of the principle of the satellite dish. That way the waves were captured more efficiently, not to mention the space they were saving with the design. Everybody, including his brother-in-arms, were shocked to see how easy the working principle really was. That very moment, I realized that was the answer I'd been searching for so long. I realized that was the key to take control, energy-wise, and create a solar panel system to capture the solar waves more efficiently. And using my grandfather's idea, I found the method to redirect the rays in such a way that the system provides an increased output of the much-needed energy. Moreover, this brilliant idea takes up such little space, it can be installed almost anywhere, and I could take it with me wherever I went. That's why it was perfect for me. I realized it had the potential to supply endless fuelless energy. I couldn't believe it. I started building the device in my backyard with my son the very next day, documenting the process step by step. It took us about 2 weeks from start to finish, and most of the parts we used I already had lying in my backyard. When the big day came, we plugged in a fan and started it. We just couldn't believe our eyes. Plugged in, the fan was spinning from nothing. I let it run for the rest of the month and plugged in all sorts of appliances, TV, radios, electric chainsaw, a vacuum cleaner, and a microwave oven. At the end of the month, I checked the mailbox, and for the first time in years, I grinned from ear to ear when I saw the bill. It was only $38, from an average of $120. Turns out my grandfather's idea led to something so practical that everyone can build the power of their homes with green electricity, especially nowadays, while investing a fraction of what they usually do. The result is a system so small and versatile, there's almost no limit to how you can use it. Use it to fuel up any electrical devices, from small clocks to microwave ovens or plasma TVs. Power up almost anything so you can spend your vacations on Easy Street. Take it with you when you go camping and enjoy green energy for your caravan or in your tent. And even become independent with a high-output system you can build in your spare time. And even though you can find some of the blueprints on a few websites, you'll discover that without the proper instructions, they're pretty useless. First, let us ask, what is the force behind this brilliant invention? All the energy I needed emanated from one single center, one single source. Imagine the sun as a big source of energy, positively charged with a massive potential of over 200 billion volts. Inside Milky Way, in the solar system, the Earth is a giant magnet, acting like a huge sponge that constantly receives almost 48.115 megawatt hours of electrical energy. Now get this, my grandfather figured out how the system captures the energy from this unique source, and it was believed it was impossible to use even a small fraction of this almost infinite source. That's because most of the energy hits the Earth's surface and goes to waste, and is lost forever. And the system was built with the technology available at that moment. Things have changed and evolved since then. With a few simple, witty adjustments, you too can grab a slice of this unlimited resource that doesn't cost any money, doesn't pollute, and will reduce your electricity bill forever. Starting from the brilliant design that grows the wave's input by converging them, I had the idea to focus the sun waves in one spot to increase the overall power output. I then thought of a system to reach this goal, and the most effective one was using the principle of the satellite dish. That way, the waves would be captured more efficiently, not to mention the space I was saving by rearranging the solar panels at a converging angle. As you probably already know, solar panels capture the solar rays and transform them into electricity, but not all panels use the full capacity of that powerful energy. The real secret lies in taking advantage of their full potential. And my grandfather, without even realizing it, discovered the ingenious method to redirect the rays in such a way that it can turbocharge the whole system. And in the next few moments, you're going to see just how easy it is to build it yourself. But here's the even better news. You'll be able to build the device with things lying around your house, because technology evolved and you don't need to buy expensive parts, so the design is cheap and simple. And because of that, you'll find all components for mere dollars on Amazon. In fact, the new blueprints are so simple that you don't have to be an electrician. Heck, my 10-year-old son could build a small system during a lunch break. Just imagine powering your home appliances with this amazing system. No more paying through the nose on electricity just to make the fat cats even fatter. Turn on the lights and TV as often as you want without having to constantly hear that nagging voice inside your head telling you that you need to turn it off because you'll end up paying a fortune. You might want to take notes because this will be short and intense. And because electric companies don't want this technology exposed, this presentation could be taken down at any time, even today. Here's a short video of the simplified system at work. Remember, this is the initial test to give you an idea about the Cold War generator. With larger scale devices, the results are impressive. And the latest improved design is much better and much more efficient. Once you discover just how easy it is to build the Cold War generator, you'll enjoy even greater savings, up to 85% or more, when you discover the simple scaling secret for getting virtually unlimited energy. You'll be able to power up any kind of household appliances, from lamps and toasters to big plasma TVs. You can even take it with you at remote cabins in the wilderness and stop worrying about electricity. What's more, because the Cold War generator is very light and portable, it makes for one of the best emergency generators you could ever hope for. Unlike wind generators, or windmills as some people call them, it doesn't need perfect wind channels, height, and weather to be efficient. And unlike conventional portable generators, there are no fumes, and you don't have to spend hundreds of dollars on fuel. In fact, there's very little to spend at all. Except from a simple maintenance check every few months, the system is basically set and forget. And because the design makes it so silent, you won't even hear it running. That's because you can install it anywhere in your backyard and not worry about consumption for 1 second. So here's why you need to try the Cold War generator today. Quite frankly, there's never been a better time for a technology like this to emerge. With electricity prices going through the roof and peak oil just around the corner, it's only a matter of time before everyone turns to alternative energy sources. But if you think about it, you'll realize alternative energy never really was an alternative. Just try to go solar without spending five figures on a solar panel system. It's impossible. Or try building a DIY wind generator that requires a degree in engineering just to set up without forking out $800. and how much wind is directly hitting your home area throughout the year. The Cold War generator, on the other hand, is extremely adaptable and will completely change the way you look at energy. It costs very little to set it up, and you can find almost all the materials and spare parts at your local electronics shop. It's incredibly easy to build. Because I needed to use the device in the middle of nowhere, I made it as simple as possible. You can get materials that usually cost thousands of dollars for a few bucks. And with my step-by-step instructions, building your own system is as easy as assembling an IKEA chair. There are no emissions, no fumes, no radiations. In fact, it's as green as it gets. And best of all, it generates the much-needed electricity so you can slash your bill by 30%, 60%, 80% or more. Here's how to get the Cold War Generator Blueprints. You need to move fast on this one because we simply don't know for how long this website is going to stay up, and we want to get this into as many hands as possible. This invention has already changed the face of the modern world, and it can do it one more time. People need to hear about this amazing device so they can break the chains of big energy and stop paying for electricity that should be available to everyone. So here's the deal. The Cold War Generator Blueprints are available in electronic format for instant download. You could be reading them just 5 minutes from now, and you can enjoy energy from your own system in 3 short days. You'll save tens or hundreds of dollars each month, and maybe thousands each year, and there will be no reason to look for other options.
Click the link in the description to download the program.